Welcome back, strangers. The luxurious Ponce de Leon Hotel in St. Augustine, Florida, had its final guest checkout in 1967. Fortunately, a year later, the hotel became the centerpiece of the newly founded Flagler College. Originally, Flagler was a women's college that became coeducational in 1971. Today, it's a four-year private liberal arts college. However, Flagler still can't get away from the hauntings and legends surrounding the old Ponce de Leon Hotel on campus and its original owner. Henry Flagler was an American industrialist from New York and founder of Standard Oil. He was one of the first entrepreneurs to see Florida as a winter getaway for wealthy northerners to escape harsh winters. He and his team of architects completed the Ponce de Leon Hotel in 1888. A gorgeous four-story, 504-room luxury hotel built in a Spanish Renaissance style. The hotel's design was so popular that it would inspire architecture around Florida for the next 50 years. The hotel had a turbulent history that began with a yellow fever epidemic that broke out in St. Augustine during the hotel's opening season, which was followed by some of the coldest winters Florida had ever had. But Flagler never gave up on the hotel. It was his favorite out of all of his properties, and one of three of his hotels that survived the Great Depression. Today, the old hotel building is named Ponce de Leon Hall and is a dormitory for 480 female students and has a dining hall. The strangest thing about the residence hall is that the fourth floor is boarded up and closed to students. It is said to be one of the most haunted buildings in St. Augustine. Henry Flagler was extremely successful in business, but had terrible luck when it came to his personal life. He was a ladies' man, and a heartbreaker. He was married three times and had countless mistresses. A couple of his lost loves are said to be trapped inside the old hotel with him for all eternity. One is believed to be Henry's second wife, Ida Flagler, who tragically suffered with several mental problems during a time when mental illness wasn't well understood. Some believe Henry's countless affairs drove Ida to madness, but it was most likely hereditary issues because her family had a history of mental illness. As Ida's mental condition continued to deteriorate, those closest to Henry advised him to have her committed to a sanitarium. She spent her last years alone, talking to the walls in her room in the sanitarium, until she died of consumption. After her death, people reported seeing glimpses of her in the hotel. Her spirit is said to roam the lobby of Ponce de Leon Hall. She is often spotted staring at one specific section of a wall in the old hotel before fading away. The wall once had an old portrait of Henry Flagler that hung there for years, before finally being taken down. Her spirit seems to be at peace, but many believe she is stuck in the hotel and unable to pass on. She is still tied to the misery and insanity she suffered while her husband did nothing to help her except spend his time with other women. The spirit of the woman in black is believed to be one of the mistresses of Henry during his marriage to Ida. She had her own suite on the fourth floor that Henry would lock her in when Ida would visit or stay in the hotel. The mistress soon realized that Henry was never going to leave Ida, so she began using drugs in an attempt to get him to notice her heartache and numb the pain. Her plan failed, and she quickly became addicted to drugs and turned her room into a psychomantium. The room was dedicated to altering the state of her mind and attempting to contact the dead. She covered the room from floor to ceiling in mirrors. Some believe she went insane in the hotel, just like Ida, from the pain of rejection and drug use. She committed suicide in her mirrored room by hanging herself from the ornate chandelier. The room is now known as a suicide room. It is locked away on the fourth floor, but students still attempt to see inside the legendary room. Those who have managed to get or see inside claim that you can occasionally see glimpses of the mistress's body still swinging from the old chandelier. Students often awaken to the sound of screams and strange noises coming from the fourth floor. Items are known to fly off shelves in the suicide room. Pictures and posters won't stay on the walls, only mirrors will remain hanging without mysteriously falling off. The spirit of the mistress is extremely restless, still angered by daily rejection she faced during her life. Students see strange lights flicker on and off on the fourth floor. Despite his personal issues, Henry Flagler lived a long and productive life. He founded the Florida East Coast Railway and greatly grew the hotel and tourism industry in Florida. He passed away at 83 in his mansion in Palm Beach in 1913. Prior to his burial, a memorial service was held at his beloved Ponce de Leon Hotel. During the service at the hotel, every open door and window mysteriously slammed shut. Henry's spirit attempted to escape the lobby before all the exits were closed. In his haste, he smashed into the rotunda, trapping his spirit inside the hotel for all eternity. When you enter the main doors in front of the large rotunda in the lobby, you can still see the face of Henry stuck in the tile, staring back at you. There is a ghostly lady dressed up in all blue that is often seen walking slowly into Ponce de Leon Hall at night. Sometimes she heads towards the dining hall and appears to be confused by all the unfamiliar furniture in the room. Other times she can be seen covering her face and looking as if she's crying. She is not one of Henry's many lovers, but she is another restless spirit still suffering the heartbreak and grief from her previous life. The lady in blue was the mistress of another wealthy man who stayed in the old luxury hotel. Every day, the man would promise that he was going to leave his wife for the lady in blue, but he would always make up an excuse as to why he couldn't do it right away, until the ultimate test of his love came. The lady in blue proudly announced to her lover that she was pregnant with his child, and expected him to finally leave his wife and marry her. However, the man denied his love for the mistress and claimed the child most likely belonged to another man the harlot had been sleeping with. Hysterically, the lady in blue packed her belongings and fled. However, she tripped on her long, beautiful blue dress while going down the stairs and broke her neck in the fall. She died instantly, becoming another heartbroken victim of the hotel. The last haunting is the most recent of the hotel and college. It is the phantom of a young boy who is a little mischievous and likes to spook students. Sometimes in the hallway at night, you can hear him asking to play and giggling to himself. Toys and bouncy balls will appear out of nowhere, rolling down the empty halls. He likes to tap people on the shoulder and tug at their clothes for attention. No one knows much about what happened to him. One theory is that he fell off the stairs or off a balcony in the hotel. Another is that he was a victim in the hotel of the yellow fever epidemic that occurred the first year the hotel was open. One source claims that none of these deaths occurred in the hotel or on the college grounds. According to the college's YouTube account, the school can neither confirm nor deny the existence of ghosts on campus. Strangers, would you attend Flagler College in beautiful St. Augustine, Florida, or would you be too scared? Which haunting was your favorite? Let us know in the comments below, and leave us a like letting us know you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe, and be sure to smash that bell button so you never miss out on one of our videos. It helps us out so much. And as always, stay strange.